rode a team time trial with Grace Brown. It was a club event for St Kilda Cycling Club. And all I had to do was try and hold on to her wheel, which was not as easy as it looks.
No, she is genetically very gifted. She is so strong, being a teammate of hers as well. She tried to lead me out once and just rode away from the whole peloton and won the bike race in Tour Down Under. And that was when I realised that, yeah, we've got a good rider here on the team. So she's very good in lots of different ways on the bike. She is showing us that she is such a good time trialist today, though. I think she's going to be posting a very strong time.
Lotta Kopecky, from being a sprinter yesterday, she became one of the world's best climbers. She's in fourth position in the general classification. 7 seconds in front of her is third, Van Vleuten. 45 seconds in front is second, Kasia Nuadoma. She's chasing a spot on the podium.
Nearly 40 seconds ahead of the time of Guazzini. There she is, crossing the line now. Brilliant ride by the Australian. Just 11 days now until the World Championships in Glasgow on the time trial. She'll also ride in the road race 3 days later. Well, the road surface really beautiful and fast here. Now she's coming up to that 600 metres to go. The road will trend uphill under this beautiful bridge. She's still thinking about which is the fastest part of the road. You can see it all the way over on the left-hand side.
She's also taken it down into the smaller chain ring on the front there. We've seen some riders keeping it in the big chain ring and just getting overgeared by the top. So she has done the recon on this. She knows that it was worth changing down to the smaller chain ring. She can keep that cadence nice and high. She's going to soak up every last bit of energy from this very loud crowd. Tight right-hand corner, and she'll click back into the big chain ring and power all the way to the line.
No mistake on that corner, the way we saw with the other rider, storming around through the straight here. She has one more left-hander, and look at the green section there. That shows you how much time she is in front of Grace Brown.
Righty, it looks like she's still stuck in the small chain ring. Maybe she's also had a mechanical. That cadence is very high. I'm surprised that she hasn't been able to go back into the big chain ring, but big time down now. That is the new fastest time.
Well, brilliant ride by the Swiss woman. Crossing the line 40 seconds in front of Grace Brown with a new best time.
And here she is. Olympic Games gold medalist against the clock, the defending champion in the Tour de France. She starts the day in third position overall. Here comes Kopecky. This is impressive. She's just outside the time of Reusser. She said she wanted to do the time trial of her life, and she is on target to achieve it. This is the first day she's ridden in the green jersey, a classification she's led since the start of the race. She's now got the third best time, 30 seconds off the pace of Reusser, 3 seconds slower than Grace Brown. She is challenging the top three overall. All decked out in yellow, it's Vollering who is down the ramp in Po. A brilliant victory yesterday to the top of the Tourmalet. She leads the Tour de France Femmes Avec Zilwift by 1 minute and 50 seconds. The world's number one ranked cyclist is number one in the general classification. She's on target for yellow.
Matt, I just got goosebumps watching her roll down the line, having your name announced at the Tour de France Femmes in the yellow jersey on the final stage, rolling down the ramp of an individual time trial. That is giving me chills. This is an exciting finale.
Van Vleuten coming through to the midway checkpoint. She's now slipping to fourth position in the general classification behind Kopecky. She goes through at 31 seconds slower than Lotta Kopecky. Kopecky started the day 7 seconds behind her overall.
This is not at all what we were expecting from the Olympic champion, Annemiek van Vleuten, known for her time trialing almost as much as she's known now for her climbing. Doesn't look like she's having a very good day. I think yesterday really would have made a huge difference. She had to go so deep, Demi Vollering cracking her on that last half of the Tourmalet.
She's been a world champion on the track in the Madison. She started her career labelled a sprinter. She's no sprinter anymore, even though she's still one of the very fastest in the world. She's a sprinter who can climb and can time trial and is throwing every last kilojoule at the finish line. Kopecky is in with the second best time, and she'll be on the podium in Po in the top three overall.
Vollering looks so smooth. She reminds me of her director, Anna van der Breggen. She is going very fast up this climb today.
Green goes to red. She's in second spot behind her teammate. It's Reusser still with the quickest time. The yellow jersey, though, she's the second fastest at the midway checkpoint, 12 seconds off the pace. And she's good enough to turn that around in the final part of this course.
Well, incredible average speed, too, considering the climb and the technical slower start. It just indicates not only the inspiration of wearing that maillot jaune, but also the form that these riders came into this Tour de France with.
Annemiek van Vleuten still full throttle to the finish line. If a dictionary was turned into a Pictionary and you looked up the word resilience, you'd see a photo of Annemiek van Vleuten. 12th today, fourth overall. Love that from Fletcher Mackay, our champion. But what we do know is Demi Vollering will be the winner of the tour. And she is sprinting all the way through to the finish. It's her teammate, Marlen Reusser, who waits in the hot seat. Her time, 29.15. Reusser will win the stage, but Vollering will be the one who has celebrated the loudest. Second place last year. She arrived with so much pressure on her shoulders. It's relief for Reusser. It's victory for Vollering, the winner of the Tour de France Femmes Avec Zwift. Second on the stage.
Well, that is impressive. 10 seconds behind the European time trial champion, particularly after the day she had on the bike yesterday. SD Worx. Amazing.
See the importance of this tour. They are lifting their performance today like we've never seen before. The shake of the head too as she crosses the finish line. The sheer relief to get through that time trial. Everything went to plan. It's all over.
And the long wait adds to the emotion.
And these two riders, amazing rivals, teammates, huge respect for each other. Now first and second in the Tour de France Femmes.
The European champion is the stage winner in Po in the individual time trial. She's gone from disbelief to this is where I belong. Is she going to break out into an Alison Jackson dance?
Maybe the Swiss version of that. She's usually a really composed sort of person, but we're seeing a little bit more joy.
I like seeing this side of her personality come through. The world's number one ranked cyclist. She arrived at the start line 8 days ago in Clermont-Ferrand with a whole lot of expectation. She's delivered in spades. She won the Queen stage. She is the queen of the tour. It's Vollering in yellow at the end of a big battle across 8 days of racing. Demi Vollering, qui est félicitée sur scène par Elisabeth Borne, première ministre.